Due to COVID-19 outbreak, pulse oximeter is now a very important gadget in our daily life. In this video, I'm going to talk about everything about pulse oximeter, how it works and how it detects our oxygen saturation level in our body and how can choose the best pulse oximeter from online and how can detect which pulse oximeter is actually fake and which is the genuine one. Without further delay, let's get started. So basically this is available around 500 rupees to 2000 rupees and beyond in India, but within 1200 rupees every pulse oximeter is made in China product. Nothing have been made in India, everything is made in China, but they will use some private labeling and they will make some make in India sticker to say that it is made in India. This is not. Everything is imported from China. So this is also, you can see in the screen, which I have ordered from Amazon at 500 rupees, also made in China. So just unbox it and every pulse oximeter will see just like this, blue or white color, and there will be some small instruction manual, and in the box it will be written quality check, but no country of origin, which country it has been manufactured is written. But according to the some rules of government, every product should have to be written where it has been manufactured, but this is not written, but it is made in China product. But I don't know how this government is allowing any product without any country of origin. So this, if you want to buy this, I have given the Best Buy link in the description with the box with some thread also given. In the back side there is written some voltage or what kind of battery is needed. Basically it needs triple size two batteries. That means you have to use double triple size batteries. You can also use some rechargeable battery, but you will not give a low battery warning after some usage. So in the physical overview there is nothing, only in the front side one button is there. In the back side here you can see I have inserted the batteries. So it is, I have inserted Duracell battery. So here you can see if you press the on and it will just switch on instantly, and it is auto switch up or auto shutdown function is there. If you do not put your finger within 5 or 10 seconds, it will be automatically switch off, but if you put your finger as long as you want, it will be switched on. So here you can see there is some red light is blinking from the finger area where you can insert your finger. But remember one thing, you have to insert your biggest finger, that means middle finger, not the index finger, to get the optimized result. So here you can see how the screen looks like. Top left yellow color, the oxygen saturation level is given there. Right side your beats per minute or the heartbeat rate is showing there, and in the middle there is some PI index. I will talk about every details one by one. In the right corner side battery level is given there, and the bottom there is some beats curve is there, but or the how the your heartbeat is pumping, just some graph is given. Now let me talk about one by one. First talk about PI index or perfusion index. This is basically the ratio between pulsatile blood to non-pulsatile blood. If you don't know what is pulsatile and non-pulsatile, basically pulsatile blood is the blood which is carrying, or hemoglobin which is carrying oxygen, and non-pulsatile is not having oxygen. So here you can see the red one is having the oxygen and the blue one is not having the oxygen. So this is basically the ratio is given there. So basically the normal ratio is 2 to 20%. If you have 20% and reading in PI index, that means you have a strong blood. If you have 2%, you have a weak blood. Next is what is pulse rate. Pulse rate, we all know the pulse rate is how much time your blood is flowing through your capillary. So this is basically a normal pulse rate or beat rate per minute. Here you can see depends upon age to age, depends also male to female. So you can check what is going to be a good pulse rate according to you. So here you can, I have talked about PI index and pulse rate. Now let me talk about the SpO2, the main thing of saturated oxygen. For that we are going to buy this pulse oximeter. So SpO2 means the ratio, not ratio here, it is a, if you talk about the 50% of your SpO2, that's mean your oxidized hemoglobin and non-oxidized hemoglobin, there will be a total how many oxidized hemoglobin out of a total hemoglobin or total blood. So if you would say there is the total all the bloods carrying, all the hemoglobin is carrying oxygen, that's mean you will get 100% oxygen SpO2 in the pulse oximeter. So how this all being detected using the small gadget? This is a very interesting. So there will be two light, one is the red light, another one will be the infrared light, which will not able to see in your naked eye. Two light is basically 650 nanometer for a red light and 950 nanometer. Inside the pulse oximeter, from one end light will be emitted and from another end light will be absorbed using some sensors. So if your red light and infrared light is being emitted and if you place your finger in between them, then the light will not be fully absorbed from another end because your finger will obstruct the light. Using these simple tricks of physics, the whole sensor or the oximeter works. So here you can see if your blood have more oxygen or more hemoglobin, then the light will fall into the sensor is less, and if you have less oxygen, there will be less absorption, more light will pass. This is the simple characteristic graph. Here you can see the blue line is without oxygen and the pink line is with oxygen. So here you can see there will be a different graph or the different light source absorption is different. So at 650 nanometer, deoxidized hemoglobin absorbs more light or absorbs more red light compared to the other infrared light. Infrared light at 950 nanometer with oxygen blood absorbs more light. So using that, there will be two ratios coming out, and from there using some microcontroller, all the calculation is being done and you are going to see some reading. Now let's talk about how to detect the fake pulse oximeter or which is genuine, which is fake. In the internet, one video was viral some days ago. There will be showing that if you put your any pencil inside this pulse oximeter, it is going to give you some reading. That means it is a fake. Is it true? Absolutely not. Here I have also tested the same thing using some pencil. Yes, it is giving some reading, but the reality is it is going to give you some readings if you are still using pencil instead of your real finger, because the pencil also characteristics just like human, because the pencil is not a fully solid, it is a wood. So some of light will be absorbed, some will be passed. From that, using this microcontroller detecting that it is just like the finger, so it is going to show you some reading. But if you now use some rubber band to detect it, it will fully check the pulse oximeter is genuine or not. So for that, you have to first of all check your reading of the oxidizer. It is right now SpO2 is 98% right now without applying any tricks. This is the normal thing. In my middle finger it is showing 98. Now what I will do, I will use some rubber band, and here you can see what I will do. I will touch it with my same finger. I have given reading have been taken before using some rubber band. Here I am using the middle finger. You should also use the middle finger. If not possible, use the index finger. So right now, just wait 1 minute after applying the rubber band, then insert your pulse oximeter, then take reading. If the reading is not being showing there and it is a null or blank, or the reading reduced from 90% to some 70-80%, that's mean your pulse oximeter is 100% working, 100% genuine, it is not fake. Here I have changed my finger and again inserted the index finger, it is going to give you the 98%, but the finger where I've applied some rubber band is not going to give me any reading or different reading apart from 98%. This is basically happening because after applying the rubber band, blood circulation from particular this finger reduced very low. There is no pulse, no blood circulation. That's why it is giving this kind of reading. So this is basically inside of the pulse oximeter. The black rubber or black area is being used for the no outside light will enter it and will manipulate the original reading. So in the manual also written that there will be might be 1-2% of error of being reading because this is a digital gadget. So now let's talk about some hidden setting. So for if you press the single button more than once, it will change the direction from landscape to create, and it will change to again portrait after pressing it 4 times. So there will be 4 direction or 4 orientation you can use this pulse oximeter. In the portrait, there will be no graph is available. Now if you hold down this button, there will be some setting will come out. This setting is basically some alarm setting, some reset, factory reset and brightness setting. You can change the brightness from 1 to 3, 4. 4 stage is given there, 4 is the highest brightness. And if you use the alarm, it will give you some alarm, but particularly this model does not have any external buzzer or speaker, so that the alarm or warning sound will come. But if you change this alarm setting some low or high, it will give you a red alert or red font, because by default it is going to use the yellow font, but if you set some alert level, it will give you a red font above that particular reading. So if you say above below 90% is warnings, then 89% is PO2 will give you a red font color instead of yellow font color. So that is the particular thing. If you switch on, in the top right corner will be the version. Here you can see 3.40 is my version right now, and also the battery indicator is given there. If your battery is low, it will also show you low battery and it will immediately switch off. So if you want to buy this particular device, I have given the best buy link in the description, and it is quite important thing, because right now health infrastructure of total India is just collapsed, so you have to take care by yourself. That's it. Thanks a lot for watching this video. If you found this video helpful, like this video, share this video. I'm going to meet you in my next video. Till then, goodbye, take care and be safe.